And it is with a heavy heart and boundless regret I submit the following evidence. Our police forces today represent more of a farce. Paralysed by legions of senior officers living in fear of taking either robust decision or action, they've descended to having virtually zero respect from us, those who seek to be policed. The last few days have seen this sink to a new low. The middle-class hissy fit that is the unwashed eco-warriors' protest has returned, parking yachts on the public highway in five cities, blocking traffic and causing major disruption. In every location, the police took no direct action. Indeed, in London, officers even guarded the damn thing and then watched and did nothing as the boat moved location to south of the river. However, one senior officer has recently taken decisive action of a sort. I speak of Met Police Assistant Commissioner Neil Basu, who decided to tell newspaper editors what they could or couldn't publish in the leaks row over messages sent from our Washington ambassador. Well, time for our police to cop this message. You're not spectators at the boat show, nor are you journalists. Any chance you could get back to doing the job?
Nick, we've had this debate before.
I mean,
the last time there was an Extinction Rebellion protest...
I changed myself to the set, if you recall.
You know, as you know, I totally agree with their mission, but I don't...
With the protesters?
Yes, yeah. But I don't agree with the way they're going about it.
OK.
And I think that, like we've said before in the past, the problem with this is what happens is the very people they need to get on side... are then put off.
But to broaden it a bit, and I hear you on that, what about police losing the plot?
Well, in terms of the police, I sympathise with them because what can they do? We live in a democracy. You know, people have the right to protest. And these were organised in advance. And this is what the police actually had to say. South Wales Police, West Yorkshire Police, Bristol City Council, police in Scotland and the Met Police all had similar statements about the boats and protests, saying that they balance people's right to protest with the public's right to go about their daily lives.
So you're familiar, June, you're familiar with Section 137 of the Highways Act of 1980,
no,
are
not,
you?
Actually.
If a person without lawful authority or excuse in any way willfully obstructs the free passage along a highway, he, she, they are guilty of an offence.
Without lawful?
Well, that blocking a road in Bristol...
But the protests were planned in advance.
So... Well, so that means you can shut roads in Bristol and Glasgow and London, Rachel?
I don't know.
I'm not quite sure what we're arguing about here. Are we arguing about
police
the fact
aren't doing enough.
That the police are trying to stop the media from printing
and
publishing leaks? Well, if that was the case, you know, half the journalistic scoops would never see the light of day.
I'm arguing the police have lost their way.
So the police have lost their way. I completely agree with you that it was an unbelievably silly piece of PR on their part.
This is Neil Basu.
To tell the press what they can and can't publish under threat of criminal prosecution if they did. In the newspaper industry, I mean, one of the only scoops I ever got on the FT was when a low-ranking civil servant handed me a transport white paper, fold the front page. But, you know, so, you know, journalists need
Sounds
to...
Sounds exciting. I wasn't used to it in the news.
Anyway,
so, in the sun.
You know, frankly, that is why... That was a red rag to a bull. You know, they must have put the backs up, the whole of mainstream media, at the same time not actually doing their job policing the streets properly. So, yes, it's been a bit of a bad week for the police. On the other hand, I agree with you. I don't think they should. How can you get ambulances, police cars around London, around these major cities?
The police
They're being blocked
way.
By boats.
Greg?
Well, I mean, I think the real... If in real terms... The police have got 19% less money than they had a decade ago. Mm. I think that's what the figures show. So there's been a significant cut in policing, right? So which means less. Now, I don't think that alone that is an excuse for.
Do you know how many officers they had at the Strand in London? Look, because I actually happened to walk
past. Did you count?
Seven buses, each with 10 officers, and another 80. Around 98 officers
watching,
standing
observing.
In the sun, looking at a blue boat. Please don't talk to me about numbers. They can whistle up 98 blokes when they need.
I think you're muddling up two arguments, basically, which I think what you said. One is, the first one is that what Basu said last week was totally unacceptable.
Absolutely.
And was, interestingly, united almost everybody in journalism from left to right.
Mm. Can we just see what George Osborne said as you're making that point? He's the editor of the Evening Standard. Said, what a mess the Met Police have got themselves into attacking press freedom. No prosecution would have a chance of succeeding anyway. I predict a U-turn today by Commissioner overruling Mr. Basu. If they stick with his threats to the media, then there will be calls for resignations.
Yeah. I mean, what he said was ridiculous.
Yes.
Basu.
An oversight remark.
The argument about policing is a different one.
Michelle.
So, from my perspective, I think that we're blaring lots of different issues, and I really feel for the police. I wouldn't want to be a policewoman now if you paid me, because I think they're stuck between a rock and a hard place. But I think in particular with this issue that you're saying about Neil Basu, which, by the way, we even heard what he said, because we're debating
let me do that for you then. OK, so this is what happened. This is the chronology. Friday of last week, he's the Metropolitan Police Assistant Commissioner, Neil Basu. The publication of leaked communications, knowing the damage they have caused or are likely to cause, may also be a criminal matter. I'd advise owners, editors, publishers of social and mainstream media not to publish leaked government's documents and to turn them over to the police. And then that was swiftly followed a day later by the Metropolitan Police respects the rights of the media and has no intention of seeking to prevent editors from publishing stories in the public interest in a liberal democracy. The publication of these specific documents, now knowing they may be a breach of the Official Secrets Act, could also constitute a criminal offence and one that carries no public interest.
Can I just add to that?
Rowing back, just gone rogue.
No, that's the classic reverse ferret.
Yes,
it's when you completely change.
Yeah. I think he hadn't thought it through.
But, yeah. Nick, you could argue that actually often we say that, you know, our public servants don't fess up enough when they make a mistake. You could argue that he was very quick to come back and
say
we made
a
mistake.
No. I didn't see the word sorry.
Or that he'd made a mistake.
Or this,
but if there's going
to
be...
So do you see now the problem? He sought to tell editors what to do and then as Grace said, to use his expression, he wrote back.
Yeah, but that's probably because someone's had a word in his ear in between the two.
Michelle.
Yeah, but at the same time, if there's a criminal investigation going on because of a leak to do with something that's breached the Official Secret Act, there should be a criminal investigation towards that leak. Do you agree or not?
Well, there is one going on.
So if you agree that there should be a criminal investigation as to who the leak was,
hold on.
It or is it not a part of this, the breach of the Official Secrets Act?
You can't seriously want senior police officers to tell editors what to do.
No, it's not.
Next thing you'll have journalists telling the police what. Hang on a minute.
I don't want restricted press, but at the same time, what he was saying was, look, there was a criminal activity in breaching the Official Secrets Act over here, so we're going to investigate that.
Okay.
Explain.
I think there is a difference. The criminality resided in the breach of the Official Secrets Act.
Yeah,
Anybody in the Foreign Office, as I was, has to sign it.
So should the journalist have to tell
me just finish. The breach of criminality
does from a lot of jobs.
Does not.
She wasn't.
No, I wasn't sacked.
She left.
Responsibility for publishing lies with the publication,
but
they are not breaking the law by publishing a leaked document.
Yeah.
According to my McCann's Law for Journalists, which I dimly remember.
Because it's the leaker who's breaking the law.
It would go against all journalistic principles for them to...
I'm afraid we've got to stop the leaks and move on. Stop your leaking.